turning ordinary stuff into something precious is a thing of fairy tales, right? Back in the day, alchemists might have spent their entire lives trying to turn something not that valuable, like lead, into something valuable such as gold. They believed that everything contained some kind of universal spirit, and so something like lead just hadn't matured enough to be something precious such as gold. Even one of our greatest scientists, Isaac Newton, wrote a lot about alchemy. But in the end, the entire tradition was based on faulty thinking. That didn't stop people from saying they had solved the riddle of alchemy, and it hasn't stopped us from asking if it's possible to turn pencils into diamonds. You might be surprised at what you hear today. So, there's no word trickery here. We're talking about your regular pencil. You might have seen an online recipe for getting a pencil and, with some fiddling around and the use of a microwave, someone claiming to have made a diamond. This can't be done and will likely just damage your microwave, so don't fall for it. It's a hoax. There is a website out there and a post from a man who claims to have wanted to get a diamond for his wife for their 10-year wedding anniversary. With photos, he explains that with a pencil, some olive oil, some cups, some cotton, and a microwave, he had made a diamond. We won't go through the process because it's utter balderdash anyway. And at the end of the post he wrote, "My wife was impressed. After all, how many women can wear a diamond that their husband actually made?" It was a prank, and he later admitted to that. But don't go yet, because we have a lot more to say about making diamonds from pencils. Let us explain something about pencils. That stuff entombed in the wood that you might have referred to as lead isn't actually lead, it's graphite, and it's said to be the most stable form of the element carbon. You might also know that diamonds are also made out of carbon. Why then don't we just turn one kind of carbon into another kind, and buy cheap pencils and turn it into diamond? Well, first of all, we have to think about the structure of graphite. The atoms in the element bond together in different ways. To form graphite, you have to have layers of a substance called graphene stacked on top of each other. Graphene is a single layer of carbon atoms bound together that looks much like a hexagonal honeycomb lattice. You've all seen honeycomb, we guess, and this is what it looks like. Because of the way graphite is formed, it's soft. A simple explanation as to why diamonds are really hard is that their atoms are structured in a different way. Under high temperatures and pressure, the carbon atoms bond and crystals form. This bonding is very strong and compact, which makes diamonds very tough indeed. We'll let a scientist explain the magic since it's above our pay grade. It's the process of atoms locking into place that produces this repeating network, this structure of carbon atoms that eventually grows large enough that it produces crystals that we can see. Each of these crystals, each diamond, 1-carat diamond, represents literally billions and billions of carbon atoms that all had to lock into place to form this very orderly crystalline structure. Those bonds for graphite, on the other hand, are not strong at all. But what we want to know is why can't we make them hard and turn graphite into a diamond? It sounds silly, but in theory it should be possible. The only problem is that according to scientists, to do that you need 150,000 times the atmospheric pressure at the Earth's surface. That's not exactly easy to do, but scientists found another way. A few rather intelligent researchers at Stanford's Suncat Center for Interface Science and Catalysis really wanted to mess around with the structure of atoms, but not make diamonds. What they were trying to do was change the physical properties of graphene to see if they could make it usable in transistors. On a very small scale, they added hydrogen atoms to microscopic sheets of graphene. These were placed on a platinum support structure, and the binding began after the hydrogen was added and a domino effect ensued. Things started to bind, and this indeed changed the structure of the graphite. What happened is that brittle graphite toughened up, so much so it became, you guessed it, a diamond. Hey, presto! They created something precious out of something cheap. The thing is, neither you nor I can do this experiment at home after buying a great big stack of pencils. This experiment was conducted at the microscopic level and used modern equipment, but does it mean scientists can now start knocking diamonds out at will? If so, have those scientists hung up their white coats and gotten into the diamond business? The answer is no, because the diamonds they made weren't the kind we see shining in store windows. The good news, though, is that diamonds produced this way can be used for industrial applications, such as coating blades to make them hard and sharp. They might also be used for electrochemical sensors. This will save some people a hell of a lot of money, since real diamonds are so darn expensive. While those diamonds were not the kind you might find embedded in rings, in 2018 Reuters reported that the man-made diamond market was growing, and part of that market included jewelry. One analyst in that report said the lab-grown diamond jewelry market was worth $1.9 billion users this year and is forecast to grow 22% annually to $5.2 billion by 2023 and $14.9 billion by 2035. We should stress that the two main ways of making these diamonds include using hydrogen, but there's also another way which involves using high pressure and high temperatures. That story said, on this market in 2018, only 2% of the entire jewelry market were man-made diamonds, but in 2035, it's expected to be 5%. Not long before that story was published, the diamond company De Beers announced that it had gotten into the synthetic diamond business. They are diamonds, but the company tells potential customers they are neither as valuable or precious as natural real stones. So, in conclusion, you can kind of turn pencils into diamonds if you manage to extract the pure graphite, but no recipe on the internet that involves using stuff you have in your house is the real deal. If you were to buy a diamond, would you go for the synthetic kind or the natural kind? Tell us in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other video, Why Are Rolex Watches So Expensive? Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.